So let me tell you what's gonna go down. Now, theoretically, Salvetta and his goons, they're gonna take you into a room. And this room is gonna be dirty, uncomfortable, but don't let that pop your concentration bubble, because once it's popped, all right? There's no rewinds, no reruns. This is a one-time hit ordeal. Next, now, this is very important. He's gonna ask you a series of questions. If you get one wrong, he will shoot you. Okay, Frank, he will shoot you. So don't be deceived that you've got everything under control, because I'm telling you, Frank, this guy is the tyranny and hands-on master of human trafficking in the Southwest region. I mean, guys that high up, they don't get there by giving control to other people. So don't get cocky on me when you're in there, okay? You just gotta trust that what I'm telling you is right. All right, now, here's a picture of Salvetta. Store that in your brain's internal archive, because you don't want to, you know, be some palooka wandering in there wondering, you know, which guy is Salvetta. Now on a more personal note, I gotta ask you a question. And I need you to be completely honest with me here. What is it that you fear most?
Honestly? Well, I guess anything unpredictable.
You picked one sweet profession, son.
I don't mean to be curt with you, Frank. We just gotta dig into the bloody corpse. Particularly, I'm not one to waste people's time, and I'm certainly not gonna start now, mainly because it makes me look like a real asshat. Are you as right as rain with this as I am?
Good.
That rings my ring as right. In case you haven't noticed, Frank, just in case, the particular branch of industry that I run isn't exactly cheap. A lot of money coming and going, but mainly a lot of money going. Frankly, it's all over the bloody shop. Do you know why?
No.
Well, let me show you. Bring him out!
Got about 70,000 of these little bastards floating around all over the world. What do you think?
What are the bandages?
Well, what do you think? They got bloody wounded, so we wrapped them up. Not that they're gonna help anyways, considering they're dead.
What do you mean dead anyways?
Look at the poor bastards, Frank. They look like a couple of rotten goats. In fact, I say the noble thing would be to just kill them right now. But I'm not built for noble, Frank. Take them out.
Anyways, my point is death. Death is not cheap, my good man, and in this industry it's all a bunch of tighty-whities and almond rocks, if you ask me. It's a bloody brief, but there's a hell of a number in the lot, as you can imagine. And I'm not just talking about the poor bastards you had a look at, Frank. I'm talking about the people who come and work for me also. We don't sell insurance, Frank. The people who come and work for me are the insurance. Everybody's expendable, so don't expect us to pay for your funeral. You know what I eat for lunch every single day, Frank?
No.
I like you, Frank. You know why?
No.
You don't know a bloody thing. Every single question I've asked you, you have no idea what the hell the bloody answer is. You know I like a man like that.
No.
It's because you and the other yous make guys like me look good. It makes it easy for me to become au fait with that stupid gentlemanly manner that you carry. Normally, I have no idea what the hell the bloody answer is to anything. So that's why I hand out the island wickers and the sugar kisses. I ask the questions and I breathe the fresh air. What I say does and what I say goes. So I say, you're in. But before it's a rock solid deal, I have just one itty bitty little question. But I promise you this. If you don't know the answer to this question, I'll cut your testicles off and hang them from the rafters and have you screaming like a big bag of wank. That I can guarantee. Are you a cop?
No, I'm not a cop.
Are you sure about that?
Rock solid.
Well, I'm not.
Now, this is going to sound a little strange, but it's the truth. If all goes cool as a mule, he's going to ask you if you're a cop. And all you say is, no, I'm not a cop. No, I'm not a cop. Now, he's going to pretend like he doesn't believe you. And the next thing that happens, it might tickle a little.
Are you giving me a fork?
No!
Are you a cop?
I'm not a cop!
Now, to make sure Salvetta doesn't start doing anything like, you know, ripping out your fingernails or cutting your ears off, you gotta go into that room with an injury. Now, you know, one might ask, what is a good injury that doesn't demobilize me if I were to succumb to an unfavored situation? Can you tell me, Frank?
Yeah, a broken nose.
Good, yeah. Good, now, you know, I don't care how you do it, okay? Just make sure it happens.
Frank, here it goes.
The bottom line here is you just gotta hang on, Frank, because if you tell him you're a cop, then it's bye-bye Blackbird.
Come a little closer.
Sorry about that, Frank, but I had to know.
No problem.
Well, on the brighter side of the bunch, you're not a cop, which means you're in. Congratulations. Care for a smoke? Frank?
Yeah.
When did you break that nose of yours?
Yesterday, why?
You're bleeding.
I don't bleed that easily.
Buggers.
Something wrong?
No. Everything is fine. Frank.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
About what?
Since you're part of the crew now, I'm supposed to wait till later. But to be perfectly honest, I just can't resist.